Flooding ravages the Americas. Rescue operations are now underway after heavy rains triggered floods in south central Chile. Authorities said at least 400 families have been evacuated in three regions. The national government has declared the worst affected areas as disaster zones. The weather office warns strong winds and rains will continue in the coming days. In the U.S., Florida State Governor Ron DeSantis has declared an emergency after flooding hit South Florida, including the Miami and Fort Lauderdale areas. The severe weather also prompted dozens of flight delays and cancellations. Now more rains expected for the rest of the week. A new cabinet has been sworn in crisis-hit Haiti. The cabinet replaces all who served under former Prime Minister Ariel Henry. They will be led by Prime Minister Gary Conille, who will also serve as Interior Minister, responsible for security forces and intelligence gathering. The new government is tasked with battling a deep humanitarian and security crisis triggered by the proliferation of armed gangs. Police have arrested two suspects in the rape slay of an 11-year-old student in General Trias in Cavite. Dennis Datu joins us with an update. Hi, Dennis.
Yes, Stanley, General Trias City Police in Cavite now has custody of the two construction workers who are suspects in the rape and murder of an 11-year-old grade 6 student in Barangay Santa Clara. According to the Chief of Police, Lieutenant Colonel Jose Naparato Jr., the first suspect, known as alias Bulok, and who happens to be a neighbor of the victim, was arrested around 12 midnight. The second suspect, identified as alias Alex, was arrested at 6 in the morning. Colonel Naparato said that the suspects allegedly had a drinking session before committing the crime. The police received a lead on the suspects after a tricycle driver reported seeing the victim before she went missing and even asked her where she was going. The victim allegedly answered that alias Alex instructed her to buy cigarettes. Police discovered that after buying the cigarettes, the suspects forcibly took the victim to a forested area not far from the victim's house. Based on the initial investigation, it appears that the suspects raped the victim before strangling her to death. The police have also confirmed, based on the autopsy report, that the victim was indeed raped. During the police interrogation, one of the suspects, alias Bulok, admitted to the crime, but the second suspect, alias Alex, denies involvement in the murder. The victim's disappearance was reported on Sunday night until her decomposing body was found on Tuesday noon. The suspects are set to be charged with rape with homicide at the prosecutor's office this afternoon. Stanley.
Thank you so much, Dennis Datu. Sports, the Boston Celtics survived a spirited comeback attempt by the Dallas Mavericks to move closer to their 18th NBA championship. Now, the Mavs nearly erased a 21-point fourth-quarter deficit, but fell short as the Celtics won Game 3 of the NBA Finals 106-99. The Boston all-star duo of Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown combined for 61 points and hit timely baskets in the home stretch. The Celtics are now a win away from clinching the record 18th title and their first since 2008. Now, prior to the start of the game, three of the NBA Finals, the league held a pre-game tribute to the legendary Jerry West. The Laker great died Wednesday at the age of 86. A moment of silence was held before tip-off. The high-scoring guard was an NBA champion, a 14-time All-Star, and one of the league's greatest clutch players. After his playing career, West became a successful executive with the Lakers and other teams that either won a championship or became playoff contenders. West is also best known for being the inspiration of the NBA logo.